गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास फाइव, माई सेल्फ रंजीत कुमार। आई वेलकम यू ऑल इन द ई लर्निंग प्रोग्राम ऑफ मॉडर्न इंग्लिश स्कूल कुंती नगर नवादा। सो दिस इज द 8th लेक्चर ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 5 विच इज फूड हेल्थ एंड हाइजीन। सो टिल लास्ट टॉपिक विच इज देयर इन योर बुक वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस टिल देयर। सो बिफोर गोइंग इन टू एक्सरसाइज आई विल गिव यू अ क्विक रिकैप ऑफ द chapter. Okay, so from beginning, as the topic says, food health and hygiene. What is food? These all things you have there, I have already provided with the notes. I will give you orally. You just listen carefully, and if someone missed that, please note it down. What is food? Food is the substance that we eat for energy, growth and protection from diseases is called food. Next is health. What is health? Means it is a condition of the body where body remains free from any illness. Then the person is said to be healthy. Next is hygiene. What is hygiene? Hygiene, it is the condition or the act of keeping yourself clean and your surrounding clean is called hygiene. Means cleanliness is called hygiene. So till here we have already discussed. Already everything is discussed. Next definition that you should know is diet. What is diet? Substance that we eat usually is called diet. Okay, next is balanced diet. Balanced diet. So diet that contains all the essential nutrient in right amount is called balanced diet. Okay, next is nutrient. What is nutrient? Essential substance that we get from the food is called nutrient. Nutrients are of 5 types. Which are those? Carbohydrate, fat, vitamins, and minerals. Last is protein. So carbohydrate, it is a nutrient that gives us energy. Fat is also a nutrient which gives you extra energy. Means if you eat excess amount of carbohydrate, excess carbohydrate get stored in the body in the form of fat. Means fat also gives you energy. Next is vitamins and minerals. These are called protective food. Fat and carbohydrate is called energy giving food. Vitamins and minerals are called protective food because although it is required in very small quantity, but it is essential for proper functioning of the body. Lack of vitamins and minerals result into deficiency disease. What is deficiency disease? Disease caused due to lack of one or more nutrient in our food is called deficiency disease. Different deficiency disease is there. Lack of vitamin A, lack of vitamin A cause night blindness. Lack of vitamin B cause beriberi. Lack of vitamin C cause scurvy. Lack of vitamin D cause rickets. Lack of iodine cause anemia. Lack of iodine cause goiter. Lack of iodine iron, cows, anemia. So these are the disease, these are called deficiency disease. Protein is called bodybuilding food because protein help in body formation or formation of cell and tissue. It also help in repairing the body. So these are called bodybuilding food. Till here, no problem. Next is, apart from these nutrients, we also need water. We also need water and roughage. What is water? What is roughage? Means water is required by our body for proper digestion of the food, and it also help in regulating our body temperature. Next is roughage. Roughage help in proper digestion of the food. These all information you have, I am just giving you a quick recap. Next is, apart from these factors, other factors that affect our health is exercise, rest and cleanliness. Means these factors are important for being healthy, to remain healthy. But apart from these factors, other factor, exercise is also healthy. Means it keeps you healthy. Means you should do regular exercise. Exercise helps our muscles to build. And rest is equally important. After taking rest, you feel fresh. So, to become your nervous system and your brain fresh, you have to take proper rest. And next is, if you are maintaining everything, you are eating a balanced diet, you are taking proper amount of water, roughage, you are doing exercise, you are taking rest, everything you are doing. But if you are not maintaining cleanliness, साफ सफाई नहीं रख रहे हैं तो भी बीमारी हो जाएगा. सो यू शुड मेंटेन प्रॉपर क्लीनलीनेस. व्हाट इज क्लीनलीनेस? इट इज हाइजीन. मींस अ कंडीशन इन विच वी शुड मेंटेन प्रॉपर क्लीनलीनेस ऑफ आवर बॉडी एंड आवर सराउंडिंग. सो हाइजीन इट इज आल्सो एसेंशियल फॉर मेंटेनिंग गुड हेल्थ. ओके सो टिल हियर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड दैट एक्सरसाइज, रेस्ट एंड क्लीनलीनेस इज ऑल्सो इम्पॉर्टेंट. नेक्स्ट टॉपिक दैट इज देयर इन योर बुक इज डिजीज. आई हैव टोल्ड यू डिजीज इज मेड अप ऑफ टू वर्ड, डिस्टर्ब्ड इज मीन्स कंफर्ट. So, this disease, it is a condition in which the body part or whole body do not function properly, then we can say this is a disease. Disease can be different. Disease can happen due to different reasons. It can be due to not proper functioning of the body part. It can be due to germs or microorganisms that enter into our body and cause disease. Diseases are of two type. It is of two type: communicable disease and non-communicable. What is communicable disease? Disease that is spread from sick person to healthy person is called communicable disease. It is also called contagious disease because it is spread from one person to another. This communicable disease generally happens due to germs. germs cause communicable disease to spread from one person to another. Someone is having cough, flu, and if he is sneezing or coughing, the water droplets that come out of his mouth that contain germs, and if you are near that person, you may get infected from that germ. So remain stay means stay away from the person suffering from such diseases. Okay, next is non-communicable disease. Disease that do not spread from sick to healthy person is called non-communicable disease. If someone asks you, give example of non-communicable disease, you simply say all the deficiency disease that happens due to lack of one or more nutrients. These deficiency diseases are not communicable. They do not spread from sick person to healthy person. Okay. Next is prevention of communicable disease. What is prevention of communicable disease? Of communicable disease. How we prevent the spread of communicable disease? The house should be properly disinfected. घर का सफाई होते रहना चाहिए. The house should be well ventilated. ये काफी हवादार होना चाहिए. Well sunlight should enter into the house, and the surrounding of the house it should be also clean. And if there is any stagnant water, means any puddle is there, where water is there, that puddle, that water should be removed, because that stopped or stagnant water is the breeding ground of mosquitoes that will give you disease like malaria, dengue. So your surroundings should also be clean. If there is drainage, definitely there will be drainage. So drains should be covered. You should not throw the waste food material here and there. You should throw it in a dustbin, and thus dustbin should be properly covered. So these are the things that you do to prevent the spread of disease. The person, the babies should be properly vaccinated. Vaccinated means they should be given vaccine. What is vaccine? A substance that is given to the body, given to the children, and that protect the person or the baby from disease is called vaccine. So the person should be properly vaccinated. Next, the next topic is hygiene. Means hygiene. What do you mean by hygiene? Already we have discussed the act of keeping yourself and your surrounding clean is called hygiene. How we can keep ourselves and our surrounding clean? So some factors, some things are there that has to be kept in mind, which you have seen in your book, which is represented by the small photos, and it is written there. So you have to take regular bath. You have to take bath with the help and so help of soap and water. After visiting toilet or washroom, you should wash your hand. Before taking food, you should wash your hands. Brush your teeth regularly, at least twice a day. And the food that is prepared in your house, that should be properly covered, because if food is not covered, then the flies will sit on that food and it will cause disease. You should take care of your eyes, proper eyes. You should wash your eyes regularly with cold water. You should trim your nails, because inside the nail germs are there, and these germs cause diseases. The garbage which you throw, it should be thrown in proper dustbin, and that dustbin should be covered. So these are the things that have to be maintained for proper hygienic condition. So almost everything I have discussed from the first lecture to the last lecture, and still if anyone have any problem, please ask, I'll be there. and try to complete the exercise. Okay, thank you for the day.